Right, okay. I go by Brictory Lap, but you can call me Tom, and welcome to the video. In order to get into the Christmas spirit, and in celebration of hitting 2,000 subscribers, I've made a massive custom set based on my personal favourite Christmas film, Die Hard. This awesome thriller from the 80s is quite different from normal Christmas films, in the sense that it's about terrorists hijacking a building, as John McClane single-handedly takes them out. Obviously, this film is aimed at an older demographic, but the video itself won't show anything inappropriate, but will make references to the movie. So, without further ado, let's get into the minifigures. The first minifigure here is John McClane. Probably one of the coolest characters in cinema, so I had to do his figure justice. He's in his classic blood-stained vest, and he has the receding hairpiece in brown. He comes with a gun for an accessory, as well as an alternate face print for when he's jumping off the exploding roof, but more on that later. The next figure here is Sergeant Powell. Another classic character, he's seen in his LAPD police uniform. He helps John from below using the walkie-talkie accessory I've given to him. I've also given him his infamous Twinkie that he's seen buying at the beginning of the film, and I absolutely love the face print that I've given to him. I think it really captures the character's personality. The next figure here is Holly Gennaro. The love interest of John McClane is seen in her old school pink worn dress. I've used one of the Lego Friends hair pieces for her in order to try and get that fuzzy 80s look that she has in the film. She also comes with an alternate face expression, which is much more scared since she has been taken hostage. The next figure here is the first terrorist of the set, Carl. He's probably the most well-known of the henchmen that goes after John McClane, looking for vengeance after he killed his brother Tony, who I've also included in the set, but after his encounter with John. Tony is seen on the chair that he is classically put in, with the shirt reading, "Now I have a machine gun, ho ho ho." One of the best scenes in the entire film. He also has the festive Christmas hat and has closed eyes to show that he's, well, dead. And the last of the henchmen here is the hacker, Theo. He was a necessary inclusion for the set, as he's such a big part of why the terrorists have hijacked the building, as it is his job to unlock the vault. He uses a torso piece that is for a Christmas jumper, and the face print that I think works really well. The next figure here is John McClane's infamous taxi driver, Argyle. He's got a groovy facial expression, as most of the film he's just vibing in the limo with his teddy bear, which is also his accessory. He's in a normal suit and is wearing big sunglasses to show his obliviousness to everything going on in the film. Awesome character. And finally, we have the main antagonist of the film, and one of the best villains of all time, Hans Gruber. Played by the late Alan Rickman, this figure was one I was so pleased to be able to make. He uses the same eyes as Kylo Ren in order to give that sinister look, as well as a gun as his accessory. I've also given him an alternate facial expression, which is of him in shock for a classic moment which I'm sure you can all guess, but we'll touch on that in just a minute. That brings us on to the build itself. And here it is, Nakatomi Plaza. This is a playset build with 1,795 pieces and 8 minifigures. It's one that I'm extremely excited to share with you guys, so let's get into each room of the playset. The first floor is the lobby, which includes a Christmas tree as well as the main desk which welcomes John McClane to the building at the beginning of the film. It also has an elevator which doesn't actually work, but it pulls off an effect to bring the whole room together. Also, below here we have Argyle's limo parked outside, as well as Powell looking up to see all the chaos going on in the skyscraper. The next floor is a mix of the main office as well as the vault. It includes a miniature Nakatomi Plaza, a long table, and a hacking station for Theo. This floor also includes the first of 3 play features of the build, in that you can twist the vault in order to show the money that is inside after Theo hacks it. The third floor here is probably the most iconic of the building, as it consists of the room where the initial Christmas party first takes place. Here we have the main elevator which has opened up to show Carl's brother with the infamous shirt on, as well as the table there with a plate on to show that it was a party. The fourth floor includes all the dynamite that the terrorists are going to use to blow up the roof, as well as the building of the girl that John McClane cheekily looks at whilst running through. Here also consists of the second play feature of the film, which allows you to push one of the glass panels out in order to throw Hans Gruber out of the floor just like he falls in the film. There are also stairs to go up to the top floor of the building, which looks like this. The final floor, not including the roof here, is the construction floor of the building. It includes a small bench which has plans for Nakatomi Plaza on it, as well as poles showing the construction and 2 crates which include the villain's weapons they bring to the building. And finally, the roof of the building has no real look to it apart from the helipad at the top and the main play feature of the set, which is the hose pipe that John McClane attaches himself in order to throw himself off the building and into the next room. This really brings the whole set together in my opinion, and I'm so happy with the final result of this massive build. Here is a look at the box art I designed for this set if it ever were to go on shelves, which I'm really, really happy with, and it might be the best I've ever made. I hope you guys have all enjoyed this Die Hard custom set, and if you want to see more videos like this from me, remember to like and subscribe. It'd be the best Christmas gift you could give me. Again, thank you all for such an amazing year and my first on YouTube, and I hope to make 2022 even better, with loads planned, so stay tuned. Anyway, thank you guys all so much for watching. I hope you all have a very Merry Christmas. Bye.
All the way home I'll be warm. The fire is slowly dying. And my dear, we're still goodbying. As long as you love me so. Let it snow, let it snow, let it snow.